Howdy folks, Effing Controller here, and I'm finally, at long last, playing Silent Hunter 5 Battle of the Atlantic. And I know that a lot of folks out there have been waiting for this for quite some time. I know that I've promised on at least a couple of occasions that I'd be doing this, so here it is. And I present it to you with joy in my heart, but also an enormous caveat. And that caveat is, you're probably going to be disappointed in my playthrough, but I'm hoping that it will be an entertaining disappointment. Kind of like the movie Zardoz, starring Sean Connery, which is actually why I'm wearing a red diaper and holding a gun. But that's neither here nor there. What I'm really talking about is my personal feelings, my bias about this game. And that bias, simply put, is just that this game is not as good as Silent Hunter 3 or 4. I do not like it as well. So I will probably be saying mean things about it. I will try to be fair, but I will be pointing out issues as they arise. And, you know, I'm just going to try to make it through it as best as I can, despite my, frankly, my dislike of this game. So I guess that kind of begs the question of why I'm even playing it in the first place. And, you know, I guess that the answer is I want to give this game a little bit more of a chance, because I am a big fan of the series, and I want to see if there's anything here to love. We can maybe together as a crew figure out what went wrong and what went right, and see if there's anything, like I said, anything that redeems this game from my bias, anything that proves me wrong. Prove me wrong, game. Prove me wrong. So enough explanatory statements about why I'm doing this. Let's just go ahead and do it. I'm gonna set up a new campaign, and my captain is going to be named Helmut Tichler. Now, if you join me for the 24-hour or 12-hour, not to overemphasize the importance of that stream, but my 12-hour charity stream that I did, I started a campaign in Silent Hunter 5 just to kind of dork around and really to test my mod set. By the way, this is heavily modded. I will include the mod list in the video description. But I started a campaign with this name, Helmut Tichler, because it's a funny joke. So there you go. Go ahead and hit accept. And you're limited in Silent Hunter 5 to certain campaigns. You unlock them as you proceed through your career. But if you want to just skip ahead, you can type silent auto, and you have the option to select any of these. Now, if you also don't have mods, the game stops. I can't remember where. I think these ones here are not included, possibly. It stops in 1943 in any case, which is pretty lame, but fortunately the modders have fixed that. By the way, this game is really only playable for me thanks to the people over at the SubSim forums. That includes several people. Too many to really list, but, you know, the Dark Wraith comes to mind. Sober certainly comes to mind. One other thing, beyond just the modders who have put so much work into this, is that anytime I had a problem getting this game to run, or anytime I had kind of a head-scratchy kind of moment about what was happening in the game, I could reliably go onto SubSim, find a forum thread, or at least a response to a thread that dealt exactly with that issue and had an exactly correct and helpful response. So that's, SubSim is awesome. So thank you, SubSim, just, you know, the community itself, but also specifically to the modders who have done so much to make this, to try and bring this game up to the standards that I think we all kind of expect out of it. But anyways, I'm going to actually be starting my career as Helmut Tichler at this coastal waters scenario, I guess. We will not be dealing with any of these areas, actually, to start with at least, but, you know, I figure it's as good a time as any to start, the beginning of the war and what have you. The difficulty is set to medium right now, but that will change. I am going to go ahead and hit start game, and I will see you guys on the other side of the loading screen. And here we are, folks. We are in our U-boat pen in Memel, which is in eastern Prussia. Which is actually a lot different from the start that you get in the vanilla game. I think it starts you in Kiel and has you attacking Britain, but this time we will be actually mostly dealing with the Baltic, which is going to be kind of fun because I haven't spent too much time in the Baltic in my miscellaneous Silent Hunter misadventures. There is our U-boat, of course, looking very, very handsome and slightly rusty. Wouldn't have it any other way. Not much you can really do here in your pen. You can run around. You can phase through people. Vroom. You can also get your feet moving at hilarious speeds. I don't really know how we will hunt silently if that's how we sound when we walk around. We will be pretty loud for any destroyer that's listening to us just walk around our sub. But anyways, there's really only two things you can do here. You can do this thing, which is this guy with the mustache, Herbert Vockel. He will give us upgrades. We can use Renown to purchase upgrades, much like in previous Silent Hunter games. I'm not going to do that, even though I do have Renown. I want to take my boat out as it is and kind of get a feel for things.
Willkommen zurück, Herr Kollege.
Or you can talk to Hans-Georg Weber, who is essentially the equivalent of Thompson from the Silent... Or, I was going to say the Silent Hunter movie. The Das Boot movie. Haha. Haha. So, he's our flotilla commander, basically, and he will tell us what to do, and we will ignore him for the most part. So let's actually just listen to his spiel, that's German, and see where he wants us to go.
Kommen Sie herein, Herr Cologne. Ich habe soeben neue Befehle vom OKM erhalten. Unsere Situation hat sich leider zum Schlechten gewendet. Sehen Sie. Nach unserer Invasion Polens haben uns England und Frankreich den Krieg erklärt. Damit hat Berlin nicht gerechnet. Und das bedeutet, dass wir der mächtigsten Flotte der Welt gegenüberstehen, der Royal Navy.
Oh, I know what that word means.
Wenn man überhaupt von Duell sprechen kann. Die englische Flotte zählt 255 Kriegsschiffe, unsere bloß 34. Das heißt, wir haben nur eine einzige Hoffnung. Unsere U-Boote.
Wait for it.
Unsere Feinde zwingen unsere Schlachtschiffe mit einer Seeblockade dazu, im Hafen zu bleiben oder die direkte Konfrontation zu suchen. Eine Situation, die wir uns derzeit keinesfalls leisten können. Nur mit kleineren Einheiten wie unseren U-Booten können wir die Blockade umgehen und auf die offene See durchbrechen. Wir haben zurzeit 46 U-Boote. Davon sind 22 gefechtsbereit. Sie werden eines davon übernehmen. Machen Sie das Beste daraus. Unser strategisches Gesamtziel, wie Kommodore Dönitz es bereits erläutert hat,
Donuts.
Besteht darin, Englands Abhängigkeit von importierten Gütern auszunutzen, indem wir ohne direkte Konfrontation zuschlagen, alle Nachschublinien kappen und die Einwohner aushungern, bis der König... Ihr vorläufiges Ziel besteht darin, die wichtigsten Nachschublinien entlang der
Soundfile was too long, I guess.
Und größtmöglichen Schaden anzurichten.
We actually can ignore most of what he's saying at this point. Because we're not going to go to Britain just yet, actually. We can only accept a mission here in the Baltic, which is fine. I don't really intend on following the mission structure of this game very much. The way that Silent Hunter 5 works normally is you select an area to do your various tasks, kind of like accepting a quest. I know that that's a silly analogy, but it's really what it is. I think they were modeling it slightly on that kind of idea. I'm going to go ahead and request this mission because, like I say, I haven't dorked around in the Baltic too much anyway, so it doesn't bother me. But he's basically his chatter was going to be more about attacking targets here. Around Britain. Also worth noting that he says that we've already declared war on Poland. It is actually August 31st right now. This man is wise. Gotta keep our eye on him. He knows things that have yet to come. So I'm gonna just skip this. I already hit skip. There you go. So we're actually ready to go. That did kind of set some of the, it explained the strategy, I guess, that, Germany was going to employ as they went through the war, because obviously they didn't have anywhere near as big of a surface navy as the British, so they had to rely a lot on their U-boat fleet. I hope that their faith is well placed. We're gonna try our best to do them proud.
Willkommen zurück, Herr Cologne.
Who am I kidding? This is gonna be a disaster. Let's go. Oh, and another loading screen. Very good, we're ready to go. Let's set a course for adventure, shall we? Onward! And our U-boat roars to life as we leave our berth here in Memel. And I do have to confess that I am a little bit sad that there's no band to play us out and there's no nurses on the dockside throwing roses into the water, but I'll take what I can get. With that said, this game is very, very pretty. I have quite a few mods installed, some of which will kind of amplify these effects. You can see there's this beam of sunlight, surely conveying some kind of sign of divine approval. And you'll also notice that things kind of just got gauzy or hazy there for some reason. Things aren't 100% perfect, but they're pretty good, so I'm pretty happy with what I've got set up here. You can see my crew, some of them have beards and goatees, and some of them are clean-shaven. Ah, jeez, okay, I'll stop remarking about your facial hair. So we're going to maneuver out of the harbor here, and this brings me immediately to one of the gripes that I have with the vanilla game, is that it doesn't really have much of a rudder control. Fortunately, there are mods that give you proper rudder controls, so that you can manually steer your U-boat. A lot of people who play this game with mods like to use manual navigation, meaning that there's no dot on the map representing your U-boat. I'm not that good at this, so I'm not gonna be doing that. So kudos to people who can do that. But I mean, obviously having these tools though, it would be very important if you wanted to manually navigate. Otherwise, you'd be kind of stuck with what the game gives you, which isn't much. So here we are. We're leaving Memel. I do want to mention, by the way, I forgot to do this before I left, but I went and reloaded, and I've set the difficulty settings. Well, I can't click on it now, but basically, the difficulty settings are that, let me go back to the actual game and I'll show you, I guess. I have the external camera enabled, and I'm doing that purely for entertainment purposes. I've realized as I've made these playthroughs that it's good to have that. Just so that you guys can see what's going on. It does definitely decrease the difficulty by a significant amount, but for a cinematographical... That's how you say that, right? I'm saying it that way. Deal with it. For cinematographical... Damn it, for the purposes of cinematography. How about that? I have that enabled. The other thing I have enabled is my map contacts. You can see... Well... Oh yeah, there you go. There's little icons and what have you on the map. They're not actually coming up like they normally do because I had to reload, but that's okay. I have that enabled, or I have contact updates enabled because I don't trust my crew to actually tell me where contacts are all the time. Even with mods that kind of address some of the technical shortcomings of this game, there are still problems like that. So I've got contact updates on... because I'm a loser, I guess. Touching on another deficiency in the game, and I promise I'll stop bitching about things here in a minute, but I know a lot of you guys like to be a part of the crew, but I'm sad to report that that's not really possible in this. I can show you, if I can remember what button it is. The crew management page comprises this. You have a few officers, a few chiefs, and what have you. You don't have near as thorough a control over your crew. And these folks, there's not very many of them, so it would be kind of a difficult thing to let only 11 of you guys be these people. I don't think we get replacements either. I think that they're just, you know, if they die, they die, but whatever. I don't know if they can actually even die, come to think of it, but in any case, I won't be naming people on the crew, and I'm sorry about that, but like I say, the crew management has been, shall we say, greatly simplified. To the extent that I'm not able to do things like that. So, while we're... Actually, let's set a course so that I don't run into the land. Beautiful. Let's take a look at the inside of our sub here. It's pretty nicely detailed, I have to say. That's one of the elements of the game that I think Ubisoft really prioritized. In my opinion, they should have prioritized other things, but, you know, it is beautifully modeled in here, and you can walk all the way through it. Here's our bed, and our little privacy screen here, a little curtain. Got our radio guy, hydrophone officer who has an empty-eyed stare, kind of disconcerting. Got some bunks, and some punks, I mean, sailors. And then we got the torpedo room here. This guy's staring at the teeth on the mechanism that loads the torpedoes. clearly very scrutinous in his work, making sure everything's up to standard. This is our torpedo man, I think, Kurt Faust. Got torpedoes just laying around. And we'll head on through the bridge again. I think there's bananas. There's bananas. This boat is bananas. And then we have more crew. This guy is wearing kind of a weird outfit. Okay. There's the cook. Hot pot of vomit. Ready for dinner later on. We got our diesels running. We got old Scarface McGee here, and then we've got our electrics and our batteries. Everything's looking pretty good. So, that's the sub. I think I'm gonna go topside here in a second. If it'll. Whoa, okay. Let's go topside here. And I will pilot us out of the harbor. And we will actually set a course beyond that to our operations area. We're going to go towards Danzig Bay. There we are. We will go to Danzig and ask the question, am I demon? All right, there we go. That'll work for now. I'm going to head actually right into the bay here, which might be a little bit risky, but I'm feeling a little frisky. I'm frisky enough to be risky. And that is just the first of many horrible, horrible rhyming jokes that I make, quote-unquote jokes, so brace yourselves. We will be moving along shortly, and I will keep you apprised of any interesting updates. We just got some radio traffic that I thought I would share. It's stated today, surprise, surprise, and it's from FDU, which I think means it's from Führer der Unterseeboot, which I think means it's from Dönitz. And it says, start of hostilities against Poland, 4:45, 1-9, which I think means September the 1st, of course, that would be logical. Attitude of Western powers, uncertain, no attacks against English, etc. forces except in self-defense or by special order. Boats to remain in waiting positions for the present. I don't do very good at the whole waiting game. I'm gonna take the fight to the enemy. So we're gonna continue on. I'm just noticing the time. Let's see if... Ah, yes. And again, on the topic of graphics, this game has some pretty spectacular sunrises and sunsets. Just the sky in general is pretty neat looking, so... Oh, and there's the moon. We have a sunset and a moonrise. Hmm. Quite lovely. Well, I guess we're gonna sail on into the sunset, towards our destiny! Oh, there's a cloud. Sometimes the clouds just kind of pop in like that. Forget you saw that. It is about 9:45, 9:44 in the morning, nice if you want to be real specific. And we are getting reports of smoke on the horizon to about 90 degrees. I'm feeling approximate today. Getting a report at 89, but 90, 89. Same diff. I see no smoke. My man must be smoking something. Normally you can at least make out some kind of splotch or something. I'm not seeing anything. Well, it's a friendly military ship of some kind. We know that much. Using our superhuman abilities. That's actually kind of weird, because I thought I had a mod installed that removed the coloration from the contact and also changed it to just a square regardless of what type of contact it was, just so that you would know, or you wouldn't know, rather, that it was a escort, or whether it was friendly, or what have you. It would just be a contact on the map. But we'll have to fix that at the end of this patrol, I suppose. Now they're heading a little bit more towards me. So maybe we'll get eyes on something. Yeah, it's saying it's a task force at this point. Friendly task force. I know that in the, there we go. There's some smoke and some weird artifacting or something. I know that in the run-up to World War II starting, the Germans actually positioned a task force off the coast of Danzig. And I can't remember. I don't remember if we ran into this during the stream or not. In my test runs, though, I have run into this task force before.
I'm
just gonna keep on creeping on, I guess. Looks like they're gonna turn. They might be turning into the bay. Your big stupid head is in the way. Let's take a look. I want to actually see if I can see them rather than just their smoke. Because of this, too, if I can't find that mod that changes the shapes, I might just disable map contact updates next time. But in any case, we also have enemy. We have enemy smoke. It's amazing that we can make that distinction, but I'm not going to question it. I'm going to suspend my disbelief. A little bit hard considering that I can't see it, but I think it would probably be appropriate for me to dive anyways. We might actually have a situation here.
Course 6.
Because this task force is running into this little duo of what I'm assuming are destroyers. Yeah, I'm going to get off the tower here. And I'm going to have us dive. This could be interesting. I'm going to have us just creep along a little bit. And we've got sonar contacts for them. I think that the enemy destroyers were... That's probably the same group. The enemy destroyers were heading like this, so... Here, let's go south.
Neuer Kurs 179 Grad.
There we go. Okay, so now we've got both groups. Well, now we have one of them. Yeah, this. This could be a thing.
Neuer Kurs.
This could be a thing that transpires. I'm probably not going to participate in this because I'm assuming that the Poles only have destroyers. I doubt that they have any.
Kind of significant capital ships.
Fergus is
making weird noises.
He must be beside himself with anticipation. I know I am.
What are you doing?
He's just laying down. He's a loud sitter, I guess. So let's see. Yep, that's a task force that I have seen before. That is the Schleswig-Holstein. It's an old, old battleship, and it's under escort by two destroyers. But, well, wait. There should be two. There we go. This guy's in the lead. So they're heading over here, yep. And they assuredly see each other's smoke. So this could develop into a fascinating display here. Oh, and in fact, I think it already has. Let me, I'm gonna just, since I'm not gonna be a part of this. Yep, he's shooting. Might as well just watch this. He's nailed this one. This one over here is on fire. You can hear the shells whizzing by. Ooh, oh dear. There's a red flare. Probably the destroyer saying, "Fucking help me." And this guy doesn't look too good. Oh my. He's looking somewhat holier than thou. Because of the holes in his hull. Okay. This one, meanwhile, he's got his guns trained on that destroyer, which also looks like it's in pretty bad shape. He, in fact, is pointing towards the other two ships. I think both of these guys are done. I really can't do anything worthwhile here, but moreover, I don't tend to get involved with escorts. Which could mean two things. I don't get involved with destroyers, because they're just not worth the tonnage. I don't like to attack them. Boy, that is a well-starched flag there. He's speeding up, it sounds like. He's maneuvering. Hopefully not towards me. I doubt that he is, but, you know. Sucks about that other destroyer. Well, he's not going to have a very good time of this if he decides to take on the Schleswig-Holstein. Let's actually go over there. Kind of handy to have these guys around because those two destroyers are screening the harbor entrance. And if they're eliminated, I can kind of just amble on in. As a matter of fact...
Kleine Fahrt voraus.
Just slow down here. You can definitely tell that is an old boat. If for no other reason than it's got a wood deck, but well, a lot of ships, even at this point, did. Yeah, the flags are glitched out. Made of plastic, it would seem. Oh, there we go. Ooh. That's gonna hurt if that lands. Oh! He's taking hits. Oh, but that other one is taking hits, too. I don't think that he's gonna last too much longer. Yeah, ooh. Those really shouldn't do too much damage, even though this ship is fairly... Ooh, but that one hit it in the gun. Wow, he's getting wrecked! Oh my god, he's getting hit in the bridge and everything. What's happening here? Oh, there he goes. Now he's shooting back. Let's take a look. That's craziness. Look at this, he's charging ahead. Even though he is completely engulfed in flame, that is fantastic. He's got a red flare going above him. How did you shoot that? Did he just shoot through? Oh no, that's technically in his... You can technically shoot that. I thought he was shooting through his own ship with the stern guns. He's moving so quickly that I don't think that they're going to be able to hit him that well. He's messing up the Schleswig. Well, thanks for playing. He's still firing. Oh, man. He's reloading. Whoa, we're getting a little lag here. Oh, oh boy. Let's go over to the German ships. Schleswig-Holstein is on fire. Let's take a little bit of resources to sort all this stuff out, but I think that... Oh no, it's still puttering along. Oh my god, are you kidding me? Well, we just had a crash. Damn it.